Okay, so now that you've created your VNet and your subnet, let's create a virtual machine in one of these subnets. So whenever you're creating a virtual machine, you're not just creating that virtual machine, you're also creating other resources to enable your virtual machine to work properly. And these other resources include the disk, and the disk contains the operating system which would be running your virtual machine. Apart from that, it also creates an NIC, that is a network interface card. And this network interface card will be connected to an IP address, a public IP address, and a private IP address through which your virtual machine can communicate with other devices. And finally, it creates a network security group. And the role of the network security group is to allow egress and ingress traffic to and from the virtual machine. So in total, there are five resources that gets created. There is the virtual machine itself, then there is the disk, the NIC, the public IP address, and the network security group. So in our next chapter, we'll create our first virtual machine in Azure. So I'll see you then. So here I'm in my dashboard. Now to create a virtual machine, you can just search for virtual machine here, or you could go to all services and underneath compute, you'll find virtual machine. So let's click on virtual machine. I'll create one. I'll click on create virtual machine, and we'll be choosing all the defaults. So the only thing that you need to fill up is basically the resource group. So I'll be choosing the resource group that I had created previously. You have to give a name for your virtual machine. So I'll just call this as VM1. And it's going to be in the East US region. And here you can choose the image that you want to run. Here you have multiple choices. You can choose your Red Hat. You can also choose Windows machine as well. So if you're using Linux, then you have quite a few options. You can choose Ubuntu, you can choose Red Hat, you can choose Oracle Linux, Debian, etc. So let's choose the default, that is the Red Hat Linux. And then another important parameter is the size. So if you click on this particular all size, you have the option of choosing different VM sizes. So I've chosen the least expensive one, which is B1S. So if you have a workload which is more CPU intensive, then you can choose a more expensive machine. So here you have multiple choices. So I will give you a documentation on all these VM sizes, so you can choose based on the kind of workload that you're running. So because this is just a very basic application that we'll be running on this virtual machine, so I'll just choose the most basic, that is the B1S. And then here is the authentication type. You can either have it as an SSH public key or a password. So for this example, let's just choose password, and I will just give a name for my user, call this as Azure user. And here is basically the inbound port rule. So select which virtual machine ports are accessible for the public internet. You can specify more limited or granular network access on the networking tab. So currently I've just chosen SSH 22. So currently I can access this particular machine through SSH. And now let's go to disk. And here you can see that a disk gets created for you, and it's going to be premium SSD. Here you have the option of choosing premium SSD, standard SSD, and standard HDD. So this particular premium SSD gives you the maximum performance. So I will give you a link in the description below. You can just check that out to see the differences between all these three disk types. So we will just leave this as premium. And you can also additionally add disks if you like. So currently let's not attach anymore. Let's just keep one disk for the operating system. Let's go to the networking tab, and this is a very important tab. So here basically you can see that it's connected to the virtual network dev VNet. If you want to change it, you can change it as well, but let's just keep it in dev VNet, and it's going to go to the default subnet. So this is the first subnet that was automatically created when we created this subnet. You can place it in another subnet as well. So let's place it in subnet 1. And here it will also create a new public IP address. So this is one thing that will get created apart from the disk that you saw in the previous tab. And it also creates a new NIC group. And this NIC group is going to be basic. And it allows the following SSH 22. So this is the same port number that we had specified in the first page as well. So it's basically this particular inbound rule. Now, if you want your virtual machine to have no access to the internet, you can just click on none. And when you do that, and if you go back to your basic, you can see that that particular setting also changes, and it gets changed from allowed select ports to none. So for the time being, let's just keep it as allow the selected port, and let's choose SSH 22. And load balancing is something that we'll see in the upcoming chapters. So the management is something that we will also see in the upcoming chapter. So another important factor is the auto shutdown. So you can basically auto shut down your virtual machine at this particular time if you wish. So this is also auto enabled and its shutdown time is 7 p.m. So this is the standard setting that we have. And in the advanced tab, you can also add custom data. So this custom data is something that we'll see in the upcoming chapters. And this is also something that's very important. So in your custom data, you can add scripts that can be run when your virtual machine gets created. So this is something that we'll use extensively in the upcoming chapter. So let's just leave it as it is. And apart from that, the others are all tags and review plus create. So let's click on create. So you can see that the validation has passed as well. And here it gives you a pricing per hour. So this is based on your local currency. Let's click on create. And let's just wait for this particular machine to be up. Okay, so my virtual machine has got created. So what we'll do is we'll try to connect to this virtual machine. So all that I need to do is I just need to copy the public IP and let's just open PuTTY. Here, I just need to give the IP address and click on open. Click on yes. So I can just give the user and the password that I created previously. And you can see that I'm logged into the machine. And the last thing that we'll check is we'll go to a resource group and we'll see all the resources that have got created. So this is the dev VNet that we had previously created in our resource group. Now, apart from that, you can see there's a virtual machine, a public IP address, a network security group, a network interface, and a disk that got created within this particular resource group. Now, apart from the VNet that we had previously created, all the other resources were created when we created this particular virtual machine. So I hope this was a useful lecture. I will see you in the next.